Hey everybody, how are you? Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training. And I want to talk about, this is going to be part of my WWJD Goes Deep, where it's the What Would Jeff Do show goes deep, where I take a lot of the concepts, tools, techniques, philosophies, and I talk a little bit more about them. And, you know, one of the things that this spurred was actually a comment. I'm also, you know, I'll get comments on one of my pages or experiences that happen here at the training center that I really want to go deeper on, because I really want people to understand my philosophy. And I want all of you to have a better idea of, you know, what I do, what we do here. And then also I want, the bottom line is I want you to be able to live a better life with your dog. I mean, that's really what I truly want. So imagine you're bringing in a dog, because this is like happens to us all the time. I shouldn't say all the time. This happens to us. We deal with some really, really incredibly dangerous dogs here. We deal with dogs also with massive leash reactivity. We deal with dogs that are human biting. They bite their owners every day. They bite other people. They chase after kids and bite them. They get into dog fights. They've got massive separation anxiety. They bark nonstop. They limit the lives of their owners. What I mean by that is their owners actually can't go out to dinner. They can't leave the dogs alone, or they can't have company over, or they can't bring their dogs any place. And then they bring their dogs here and we eliminate all their problems, and the dogs are much calmer, and the dogs also learn obedience. And we get a lot of dogs that are low confidence, and the dogs build up their confidence. A lot of owners then are concerned, rightly so, I guess, that is my dog, like my dog doesn't look happy, or my dog doesn't look as excited right now, or my dog looks sort of bored. And I'm thinking to myself, and we talk about this with owners all the time, it's like your dog used to bite you daily. Your dog has bitten your kids. Your dog has limited your life. You cannot do anything with your dog. You cannot do anything with yourself. You are a prisoner of your home. And you're worried if your dog is happy or not? So, no, I don't want you living with a sad dog, but when you get rid of a behavioral issue, there is a moment, a progression, where it does take time for your dog to, like, process all this new information, take the old coping skill, which was biting, barking, limiting your life, and now it has to reframe all of this into like something else, meaning I've stopped all the bad behaviors and now I sort of don't know what to do. We teach the dogs what to do, and now it's up to you to continue teaching the dogs what to do. Or have you ever thought that your dog was always anxious, nervous, fearful, and it used to cope with that with reactivity? So instead of barking, now it's shaking a little bit. Instead of rushing the front door, now it's not rushing the front door, but it's shaking a little bit. And the shaking is just lack of racing towards the front door. When people come in the house, your dog shakes. Well, that your dog used to bite people that came in the house. So I think if you're familiar with addiction and then getting rid of an addiction, a lot of this makes sense. And or being addicted to a substance and then not using that substance anymore, a lot of this makes sense. But let's go deeper into this. Is that why your dog started all this stuff anyway? Because you were worried if your dog is happy or not? Is that why you never corrected it for unwanted behaviors? Because you didn't want your dog not to be happy? Because when you did it the first time, it appeared that your dog wasn't happy. when your dog bit you and you corrected it with meaning, your dog looks sad. So then you stopped correcting it because you were so worried whether your dog was happy or not. Is that how all of this started? Is that why you are not doing it? But let's prioritize things. Whatever happened to your human happiness? Whatever happened to that? Why are we not prioritizing you? You deserve to be happy. And you're not happy. You're miserable. Your dog's biting you every day. Your dog bites guests. You can't bring your dog out anywhere. You can't drive your dog in a car anywhere. You can't go to friends' houses. You can't have friends come over. You are a prisoner of your own home. You can't hug your spouse. We have clients who cannot hug each other because their dog will bite one of them. Isn't that important? When did that stop being important? When did a dog have so much power that it makes the decisions of who comes and goes, who gives physical affection in the house, where you go, if you go? Since when did a dog make that decision? Self-worth issues, self-esteem issues. Man, we can shrink the hell out of this, but I just don't got time, but we can go deep into it. Well, Jeff, you did say this was a What Would Jeff Go Deep. Why don't you? Because that's another video. All right? Damn it, I want you to be happy. I want you to live a good life with your dog. So, at the beginning of rehab, during the beginning of your rehab process with your dog, we're not talking about sit, down, play, stay. We're not talking about obedience. That's easy stuff. We're talking about changing the way your dog thinks about the world. That's hard stuff. Sorry you don't like not biting people. At least you're alive. Because at the rate you were going, buddy, it wasn't going to end up like that. All right? Badly in love with you. Jeff Gelman, Solid Canine Training. Take care. We're going deep. We went deep. This one was deep. I could go deeper, but I'm running out of time. Love you.